Hi, thank you for watching another video blog. Everything wrong with New Age spirituality. There are three things that are wrong with the new form of spirituality, the New Age spirituality. Now, New Age spirituality can be anything from, people reading cards, or using gemstones, or channeling, or chakra, or yoga. You can look it up what this is, New Age kind of spirituality. And meditating. And some of these things have value, but they leave three very important things out of their whole belief system, if you can even call it that way. The first thing that they leave out is the most important, God. If you talk to New Age gurus, they will never talk about God. They will avoid calling a unity that is God. They refer to it maybe as the universe, or like the energy, or anything like this. But they will not say it is God, because that's against their idea. They are revolting against God. That's the whole belief that they have. It's not about obeying, it's about revolting. That's the problem with New Age spirituality. They want to revolt against traditional religion, mainly Christianity. But also they're of course not fond of Islam or Hinduism, anything that's traditional. They want to be new, that's why it's called New Age. And that's why they leave out God. They don't want to mention God. And you can say, well, you know, what does it matter? You know what they mean, they say the same, but it's not true. God is something totally different than just the universe or the energy, because that means that it's something that doesn't have a plan or just doesn't have a conscious. It's more like something that is, like, for example, the soil. It is there, it has a purpose, but it's not having a conscious or a choice for itself. And if you read, for example, the Bible, they said God created us like his image. And if we say God is just the universe, this means that you just say we are better than God. God is just the place where we are. He doesn't decide things. He doesn't have a plan. He doesn't have a conscious. But he has the greatest conscious, of course. He is the conscious. He is your conscious. And that's really my problem with these New Age kind of beliefs. Now, the second thing that's wrong with New Age is that they leave out another very important element. And that is your ancestors, our ancestors. Ancestral worship is common in basically all religion. It's a natural thing. It is as natural as believing in God. Worshipping God, worshipping your ancestors. It's very natural. This is also regarded as something silly, outdated, and not part of the New Age idea, because New Age is all about revolting to benefit yourself. They all say, oh, we're part of the universe, we're all part of the great energy, whatever. But in the end, these people are just not believing that at all, that they are part of something. They only use this belief for themselves, which clearly sounds like Satanism, does it? They don't care about ancestors because they think that, you know, it's not important. I am who I am. I have to fight for myself. I have to strengthen myself. I need power, you know, very power lust is what they have, a lot of powerless. And that's why they discard the worshipping the existence of their ancestors. Like I say, it's a revolting belief. They revolt against traditions, against traditional religion, against traditional natural belief. So of course they revolt also against worshipping ancestors, because they want to seem as, you know, they don't want to be part of that anymore. They want to separate themselves from it. Meanwhile, in traditional natural religion, can be Christianity, can be Hinduism, can be a natural religion, they respect the ancestors. This aspect was still ingrained in the belief. So, you know, this doesn't fit into the New Age agenda. And like I say, sounds more like Satanism. Now the last thing that is wrong with New Age spirituality is that they leave out the importance of family. I see none of these New Age gurus or people care a lot about their family. Now, I'm generalizing. There might be people that really care about their family. But in general, I see the tendency is not to be focused on family. They're focused on their own hobbies, which to me, it's more like a hobby. Many of these New Age gurus are childless, don't have children, don't have a family, are not interested in that. Or they have maybe one child, which is not really like a family. This family is supposed to be very extended. You know, you have your brothers and sisters living with you, your aunties, your uncles, your grandparents, etc. They're more focused on staying by themselves, and they're focused on doing things for themselves. So they're not really family oriented. For example, if you look at the Amish, that's how a real religion is supposed to be. It's all centered around the family. And that is the main reason in this material world to exist. That is to have a family and to build everything supporting that family. And many of the things that these New Age people do have nothing in support of their of a family, if they even have a family. They're very, in a way, nihilistic, and therefore I rather deem it as Satanism and as something that you should be afraid of, that you should stay away from. Because all these three things, God, ancestors, family, if you leave them out, if you don't include them in your belief, then there is no belief. That is belief. These three elements are what is belief, nothing else. And if you leave them out, it's just about yourself, it's about your ego, and that has really a lot to do with Satanism. Like making yourself, your ego, stronger. Like cut all the ties with family, with God, with ancestors, and focus on yourself. And that is what I see in all these New Age books. It's all about how can I empower myself, how can I become stronger, smarter, richer, better spiritually. It is all about themselves. It's a very narcissistic, egoistic movement. And like I say, it has elements of Satanism. So, it has nothing to do whatsoever with real religion, with enriching your spirit, with your conscience, and be a servant to God and nature. Now you might say, hey, but you are making these videos about gemstones, isn't that a New Age thing? Well, let me explain. Gemstones, for example, are natural. They are materials that you can find in this world, just like you can find plants, animals, and you can use them to stay healthy and to stay strong. They're just tools, and these tools have no further meaning in it than only that. They help you, for example, to get rid of some extra energy that you have, some disturbing energy. Like you have stress, you can hold a mountain crystal and it will, like a medicine, will release the stress. Nothing more than that. It just helps survive in the material world. can help you open up a bit for the spiritual world. But you have to be really careful. You cannot just use them. You have to be aware of the risks, because some of these stones can be quite strong. But it's not a belief in itself. It's not that these stones are now everything that is important in your life. It's not religion. It's just a tool. That's it. So my conclusion is, stay away from New Age spirituality. Focus on traditional religion and find out what it's about. God, ancestors, family. Those are the elements that matter. The rest you can leave out. Thank you for watching and see you next time.